One of the things that we thought of as a way of organizing our creativity on THX was something we called cubistic sound, which is that each scene was a cube of sound, and it would have a certain quality to it that was different from the next scene, which was another cube that was slightly different, and the scene before. So here we are in the trial, and I took my cue from the fact that everything was photographed through panes of glass. This was shot in a recording studio control booth. And so there's glass behind glass, and you see reflections of people in the foreground. So I thought, what's the audio equivalent to this? At the time, I was listening to some compositions by Steve Reich, who was a San Francisco composer, who had a technique of doubling up sound. And I didn't know how he achieved this, but I looked at the equipment that we had, which was, compared to what we have today, Stone Age equipment. But I thought, if I take the voices and thread them through this first machine, and then instead of winding up on its spool, I thread it through the other machine, through its sound head, and then through the other one over here, and then the next one, and finally I had this crazy eight loop of film. And what that meant was that you'd hear a voice, and then the film would travel to the next sound head, and then you'd hear that voice again. And then a second or two after that, you'd hear it again.
This is not a race issue.
We must be destroyed. We must not continue to consume these erotics. We must exterminate the source of sin. Economics must not dictate situations which are obviously religious.
Then I took the original voice and isolated that so that at least you had a chance of understanding what was being said. And that was placed relatively loudly in the foreground with all of this repetition chatter going on in the background.